Hey guys, this is Aaron from ASMR-inducing, and for this video, I'm going to be showing you the Nintendo Switch. So, I got mine last week, and it was, of course, really hard to get. It's still hard to get, but I got lucky off of Amazon and was able to finally snag one. So I do have to say that I haven't been a big Nintendo fan in the past. I've always bought their game consoles, but only bought a handful of games. So I hope that the Switch will be something of a new direction, and it is so far. It's basically like an evolution of the Wii and the Wii U together in a brand new system. So this is the case that I got for it. It's the official Nintendo soft case. So it's pretty nice, you know, it's bare bones, right? It does hold some games and some minor accessories. So this is the inside of the case, and I have three games for it. I have a 1-2 Switch. I have Zelda, which is inside of the Switch right now, and then I have the new Bomberman. And then there's also like an official cleaning cloth that says Nintendo Switch in red in here as well. So here is the console itself, and I do have a screen protector on the front, a glass screen protector. So I was thinking, I usually don't do screen protectors, but in this case I just decided that it might maybe a good idea to do that. So I just got one of the most popular screen protectors on Amazon, and we'll see how it goes. I know there's been some reviews on some screen protectors, like melting on the screen, but I don't know. I don't think it was a widespread problem, but anyway. So the Switch has the power button here on the top, and the volume up and down buttons right here. In the middle seems to be vent holes here to aid in the system cooling, And then your headphone jack is on the top. And then lastly, you have the game card slot. Take that out, then you can see that this is Zelda, and just pop that back in. Okay. On the bottom of the Switch itself, it is a USB-C jack on the bottom, so yeah. You can use any USB-C cable, and then some venting holes also on the back as well. And of course, the Nintendo Switch logo and the serials and whatnot. Okay. Oh, and then you have the little kickstand, which I agree was a design flaw, because It does not come out far enough of an angle to really be useful when you have this propped on a flat surface. Definitely, I would call that a design flaw. And then also hidden underneath the kickstand is the slot for your micro SD card. And for mine, I bought the SanDisk 128 gig for my downloaded games. Okay, so that's about it for the base unit. So now I'll take off the Joy-Con controllers. These are the Joy-Con controllers, and when you feel them for the first time, they feel, in my opinion, they feel high quality. You know, I'm an Xbox One player mostly, and so I feel like the Xbox One controller is really the epitome of the ultimate like gaming controller. It feels really solid, and it's just a natural evolution of the Xbox 360 controller, which I felt was a more mechanical feeling, but the Xbox One controller is really the perfection of the controller, as far as my opinion goes. And so I pretty much base everything, my opinion on other controllers, based off of Xbox One. And so when I hold the Joy-Con controllers, I feel like they are very high quality. And of course, if you do buy them separate, they are going for, I think, $70, something like that, $70. So they are actually more expensive than like an Xbox One controller, which is surprising. They really should be cheaper than an Xbox One controller, but they're priced higher. In fact, most of Nintendo's accessories are priced higher than accessories for Xbox or PlayStation. But anyway, yeah, I feel like the build quality is great. All the buttons are nice and clicky and solid. There's, of course, your Z buttons. Here are your triggers. They're not analog triggers, so they're still digital, you know, digital triggers, so they don't have any kind of movement except basically on and off. You have your shoulder buttons here, and then you have a minus here and a plus button, and those are basically kind of like your start and select buttons. Like for example, in Zelda, they bring up like a map, or they bring up your inventory. So it's kind of like your start and select. And then each side has the analog stick, which I feel feels perfectly fine. They feel smaller than regular analog sticks, but I don't know, I don't have any problem with them. They feel fine. They, you know, they work for this kind of configuration. And then on the left Joy-Con controller, you have up, down, left, and right, and basically this is their replacement for a traditional D-pad. And they did that because the Joy-Cons are supposed to be kind of like mirror images of each other, where you have the ABXY on this side, but then on this side, you really needed the, you know, Nintendo felt that they needed to have the same configuration where it's four individual buttons, because when people are playing with the Joy-Cons horizontally, right, each one has an analog stick, and then each one has four face buttons. So they didn't want to make one side have a D-pad and the other side not have a D-pad, so they pretty much removed the whole D-pad and just made them face buttons for up, down, left, and right. Now, if you buy the Pro Controller, then I believe that brings back the traditional D-pad on the left, and then you have your regular face buttons on the right. But on the Joy-Con, it's rated separate. And then on your left Joy-Con, you have this funny-looking button on the bottom. It's like a square with a circle inside of it. I think they could have done something better with that, but that's the capture button, and right now it captures a screenshot of the screen that you can share out to Facebook and Twitter. I hope they offer more methods of sharing those things, because it's just Twitter and Facebook right now. And then they said in the future it's going to have functionality where you can record video from the Switch and share that. So that would be really cool. I would like that. And then on the right Joy-Con, you have the plus button, your face buttons, A, B, X, Y, and then you have the analog stick, and then you have a home button. And that brings you back to the main screen of the Switch. And then you have your shoulder buttons here, which they call SL and SR. And there's also an additional piece of hardware that you can slide on top of this. I don't have it here, but which actually gives you more surface area to put your to rest your fingers. So it actually makes the Joy-Con a little bit bigger that you can press those shoulder buttons easier. So I'll go ahead and turn on the Switch. So this is the home screen, and this is optional, you can turn this off if you want to. And the home screen basically, I guess it's more of a lock screen. I like that it shows you some news on the side. Each time I turn it on, there's like new updated news on this side. So I do actually like that. And so you just have to click. You have to click a button three times to unlock the screen. Oh, what's this? So, this is the main navigation menu. I guess this is similar to the Wii U. And I wish they would have some additional functionality, like being able to shrink down the little square icons here, so that I can fit like all on one screen. I hope they add that, just like what they added to the Wii U. But yeah, so pretty much it also shows you if the game is on physical media or if it's a downloadable content. Shows you the time and your Wi-Fi and your battery power. And if you go to one of these games, then you can press the plus or minus buttons and you can choose some options for updating the software. Manage your software, like archiving and deleting. You can look at your rewards program and other information. So pretty nice. And then on the bottom left here, it shows you what play configuration that your hardware is in. So it's currently in Joy-Con, in loose Joy-Con configuration. So if I attach these to the Switch itself, then it will change. It'll indicate here that it's in a different play mode configuration or docked. It'll show that. So that's pretty interesting. And then on the bottom, you have news. You have the Nintendo eShop, album, controller options, system settings, and sleep mode. So, just some games here. I have the physical Zelda Breath of the Wild, which I'm playing through right now. And then I just bought a Fast RMX from the Nintendo eShop. I wanted to have a digital title. And then the demo for Snipper Clips just came out. And that one's an interesting demo. And then I have my physical copy of Super Bomberman R. But it shows it is an empty icon there because it's not in the cartridge slot. And then I got a Neo Geo game, Metal Slug 3. They have some of the Neo Geo titles on the eShop right now. And that was a digital title. And then went to Switch, which is also the physical game that I have. So if you go to the album, I have. Here's a photo that I took. Let's go full screen. There's a photo that I took from that scissors game. And the scissors game is pretty interesting because each player controls this like funny looking character. And those characters can overlap each other. And then you can press a button to cut out that shape. So if you overlap the other shape, it's gonna cut out what you're overlapping. So through cutting or like twisting the character into a different shape, then you can solve the puzzle on the screen. So yeah. And then this one here is a screenshot of four player Bomberman. And yeah, it's I haven't played a lot of it so far, but I did do a four player. And I found the computer was actually pretty difficult to beat on normal mode, which is different from previous Bomberman games that I've played. It's always been that you can pretty much beat the computer pretty well. But in this one, the computer is actually a level of difficulty harder than normal, which I thought was interesting. So, yeah, that's about it for that. So we can go to the news section, and this is where it shows you some news. So the first one is get ready for Xenoblade Chronicles 2. What's new on the eShop for this week? So that's nice. On the eShop, it definitely needs more. It needs to be fleshed out more because, for example, there's no area for demos, and so the only way that I found out that there was a demo was through the news section. So I really like, for example, if I go to where is it? There was a demo, yeah, for Snipper Clips, and but it says it's $19.99 to buy it. But if I go into it, then you can see, oh, there's a demo. But there's no way to know that from the main screen here. There's no demo area, right? There's recent releases coming soon and an enter code. So they definitely need a demo area here quick because I can't just, it's going to be a hassle to really go into each one of these and see if they have demos or not, or looking at the news section, right? It's just too much of a hassle. So, but, I'm sure these changes will come in time, hopefully. And, yeah, but yeah, you can scroll through. Oh, it's also a touchscreen as well, so you can, navigate that way, but I'm trying to actually not touch it. Touch the screen too much. I mean, there's no need to really do that. Yeah, so far I'm liking it. I got about 3 hours ish of battery life with Zelda, and I think that I was expected to get 3 hours or less battery life on Zelda. And I've just been plugging it into the dock while to charge it every day. I've tried it on my TV and it's fine, but I'm usually just having this bug by my computer while I'm editing or something, and then just picking up the Joy-Cons and just playing a quick game, right? So that's pretty much what I've been using it for. And yeah, I'm looking forward to like Mario Kart, the new Mario Kart, the new Mario, obviously. And hopefully like Sega's going to be releasing some Sonic. I know the new Sonic Mania is coming out. I already have that pre-ordered. So yeah, got some good variation of titles coming out. So yeah, we'll just see how it goes, but I'm liking it so far. For you guys, if you've gotten your Switch already, let me know like what titles that you've bought and if you're liking it so far, or if you've gotten any problems with it. So far I haven't had any issues, but I know other people have reported that there's been some issues with like the left Joy-Con not connecting up quickly, or yeah, some SD cards melting, or some screen protectors not working right, you know, melting off or whatever. But so far mine's been perfectly fine. I'm gonna bring it on a trip here pretty soon, and so I'll be able to see how it plays on the road. So all right, well, I hope you enjoyed this overview of the new Nintendo Switch. And again, if you got one, go ahead and comment below the video and let me know how you like yours. Okay, thanks guys.